This is planning's online e-permitting portal. The first page that anyone sees when they click on a link on our web pages or wherever they happen to enter from. If they have never been here before, they have to register, of course, and that's what you see on the right-hand side. You register different if you're a citizen or a property owner from if you're a business or a contractor. Then once they get set up and set up their password, they can then log in. And then they're allowed to apply for many permits, from trade permits, building permits, zoning permits. And this is the entire list of what we have available right now for everyone to sign up for on the portal. We have plans, however, to expand this list and make it much longer. Now, before, everyone would have to hand fill out this long application, and then someone would take this information and put it into our system before. Some items now are even pre-populated if they already have an established account in our system. So they don't have to continue to type in a lot of items that would be identical, such as their name, their address, their phone number, and information like that. Now, once someone's very established, such as this construction user, they can see everything from their historical permits to permits that are in progress. And businesses such as construction companies can have multiple users underneath each company. So businesses and citizens are able to see their active and their historical permits, and they're able to even request an inspection. Once they paid for a permit, they're able to print their permit. And any balances that they happen to have owed, they'll appear at the top right, including land use applications, which we don't have yet established as being able to apply for, but they can, however, pay for them online. This feature also, we have plans to expand it in the future. Now, once someone applies and they complete an application on the portal, it will appear to staff in a queue that is checked consistently. The staff member will check over the application to make sure everything is correct and that everything that is needed is present. If it is a permit that does not need to be reviewed, the staff member changes the status so that the client is able to pay on the portal. If it's a permit that needs to be reviewed, they change the status to reflect that so that it then appears in another queue for the plan reviewer to then go over to the next processes until approved. Then the permit can be paid and issued. That's permits such as building permits. Anyone with access has the ability to see everything that has taken place with a parcel that was a time to get all information needed. A staff member would have to contact several other staff members, look through many files to compile everything that had taken place with an address. However, now we can see it all in one place. So we have separation here of permits, applications, land applications, everything for one particular address. Now in the future, we have plans to have applicants would be able to apply online for planning commission items, and all would be captured within the system so that the staff can see requirements such as specific conditions required under a conditional use permit. This all allows both staff and applicants to review the implementation of Project Docs is another one. That is a virtual plan review system. This will allow both applicants and staff to review all the comments, like you can see in the example, make changes, and they can also be able to see instantly the status of their plans. And once approved, they will be able to download stamped plans, all which is saved to the record in the system forever. And this is all to help in the now 24/7 environment of planning.